Triassic animals can be regarded as weird from a modern perspective because they represented early evolutionary experiments and transitional forms in many lineages. The Permian-Triassic extinction, which marked the end of the Permian period, was still occurring as the Earth was beginning to recover from it. About 90% of marine species and 70% of terrestrial species were wiped out during this extinction event, creating new ecological niches for organisms to occupy. In this video, we'll talk about a few of the elements that helped in the formation of the weird Triassic species. Number 6 is experimenting with evolution. Through evolutionary processes including mutation, recombination, and natural selection, organisms investigate and produce novel genetic and phenotypic variations. This process is known as evolutionary experimentation. This experimentation frequently happens as a result of shifting environmental factors, ecological opportunities, or the presence of vacant niches. Intense evolutionary experimentation took place throughout the Triassic epoch, which may have contributed to the strangeness seen in those animals. The Triassic period provided an ideal environment for evolutionary processes to take place after the Permian-Triassic catastrophe. Organisms have the chance to investigate and take advantage of novel adaptation opportunities due to the abundance of ecological vacancies and decreased competition. The evolution of characteristics and body plans was more flexible and experimental because there were no fixed evolutionary limitations. Diverse kinds of creatures underwent rapid diversification throughout this time, filling a variety of ecological niches. The evolution of novel morphologies, behaviors, and ecological tactics was the result of this adaptive radiation. In order to evolve uncommon and frequently weird traits, organisms experimented with various modes of movement, eating tactics, sensory adaptations, and reproductive behaviors. The transition from more ape-like ancestral species to the embryonic stages of numerous current taxa also took place throughout the Triassic period. The investigation of novel evolutionary pathways and the formation of distinctive traits, which would subsequently be improved in succeeding times, were made possible by this shift. Evolutionary experimentation was made easier by the availability of unique ecosystems, temperature variability, and the absence of contemporary predators. Different environmental factors favored particular features and adaptations, resulting in a wide variety of odd forms. Number 5 on our list is adaptive radiation. During a process known as adaptive radiation, a single ancestral species rapidly diversifies into a number of new species, each of which is adapted to exploit a particular ecological niche. It frequently happens when old rivals or predators are eliminated or when organisms come across new ecological opportunities. A notable instance of adaptive radiation occurred during the Triassic epoch, which contributed to the peculiarity of the animals that lived here. The Triassic world was characterized by empty ecological niches and decreased competition after the Permian-Triassic extinction. As a result, surviving lineages were able to take advantage of new habitats and resources without having to compete fiercely with previously dominant species, creating an environment that was ideal for adaptive radiation. Different selective pressures and ecological difficulties were faced by species as they evolved and colonized different habitats. In order to fill certain niches, this led to the evolution of a vast variety of morphological, physiological, and behavioral adaptations. A wide variety of distinctive and frequently strange species, each specialized for a particular ecological function, emerged as a result of the rapid diversification of lineages. For instance, some families of reptiles underwent adaptive radiation in the maritime environment. Ichthyosaurs, nodosaurs, and placodonts are examples of marine reptiles that have evolved into several species, each with unique adaptations for different aquatic lifestyles. The dinosaur and crocodile ancestors, archosaurs, evolved into a variety of forms on land, experimenting with different eating methods, body kinds, and means of mobility. Strange and distinctive body designs, behaviors, and ecological interactions emerged as a result of the Triassic adaptive radiation. By enabling quick evolutionary experimentation and the filling of void ecological functions, it added to the diversity and peculiarity of the Triassic species. Number 4 is new ecologies. Novel ecosystems are those that develop as a result of substantial environmental changes, frequently brought on by human activity or natural disruptions. In contrast to past or pre-disturbance conditions, these ecosystems show distinctive combinations of species composition, relationships, and ecological processes. The creation of unique environments throughout the Triassic period contributed to the evolution of bizarre animal life. The Permian-Triassic extinction event drastically altered the world's ecosystems, leading to the extinction of a large number of species and the dissolution of long-established biological communities. New and unique ecosystems developed during the Triassic epoch, shaped by the surviving creatures and the changed environmental conditions. Triassic animals' evolutionary trajectories and observed adaptations were probably influenced by the particular combination of environmental conditions found in these nascent environments. The emergence of unusual morphologies, behaviors, and ecological tactics was made possible by the absence of well-established ecological interactions and the availability of vacant niches. Number 3 is climate alterations. When we talk about climate variability, we mean variations and shifts in climate patterns over a range of temporal and spatial ranges. Climate change throughout the Triassic period had a big impact on how strange and evolving the animal life was at the time. The Triassic epoch was marked by a variety of climate features, such as dry spells, aridity, and changes in temperature and precipitation. Changes in atmospheric composition, shifting continental configurations, and interactions between oceanic and atmospheric circulation patterns are just a few of the causes of these climate shifts. For instance, animals adapted to live in habitats with limited access to water in dry or semi-arid climates. This resulted in the creation of particular adaptations, including highly developed water-saving mechanisms, the capacity to withstand desiccation, or adjustments to eating habits to take advantage of scarce food sources. Furthermore, diverse habitats and ecological niches were produced by the Triassic world's geographic climate fluctuation. Regional variations in the evolutionary trajectories and peculiarities of Triassic creatures resulted from the fact that organisms in various locations confronted various climatic difficulties and possibilities. Number 2 on our list is the coexistence of ancient and modern traits. The simultaneous presence of traits or features in an organism that may be linked to more recently evolved qualities, as well as traits that can be traced back to ancestral forms, is referred to as the coexistence of ancient and modern traits. Numerous creatures, particularly those from the Triassic period, exhibit this phenomenon, which adds to the peculiarity and complexity of their biological makeup. Through genetic mutations and natural selection, new characteristics and adaptations can develop during evolution. Not all ancestry features are completely lost in the process, though. Even though new traits and adaptations develop over time, some traits that were advantageous to an organism's survival and ability to reproduce in the past may continue to exist. For instance, Triassic reptiles display a combination of evolved and primitive characteristics. While some reptiles continued to exhibit primitive attributes like sprawling limbs and gaits, others evolved more modern characteristics like erect limbs and an upright attitude. There are a number of reasons why ancient and modern features coexist. First, some ancestors' features might have persisted alongside more modern traits because they continued to offer functional advantages in particular settings or ecological contexts. The total replacement of ancient features with new ones may be constrained by evolutionary constraints, such as genetic and developmental restrictions. Third, the mixing of ancient and modern features can occur when closely related species hybridize or exchange genes. Number 1 is ecological vacuums. When a large number of species become extinct, empty ecological niches result, providing possibilities for new organisms to fill those vacant roles. These are referred to as ecological vacuums. Ecological voids result from significant environmental disturbances like mass extinctions or the creation of new ecosystems. Understanding the peculiar behavior of Triassic species after the Permian-Triassic extinction requires an understanding of ecological vacuums. The Permian-Triassic extinction event, often known as the Great Dying, was a cataclysmic occurrence that wreaked havoc on Earth's ecosystems and caused the extinction of numerous species. Ecological voids were left behind as a result of this catastrophic extinction in both marine and terrestrial settings. Resources and habitats that were empty because of the extinction of dominating species were ready for exploitation. organisms had a better chance of surviving and procreating if they could adapt to changing environmental conditions and take advantage of undiscovered resources. As a result, the lineages that survived underwent rapid diversification, and new species appeared to fill the ecological functions that were left vacant. So this was all about the weirdness of Triassic animals. The unusualness of Triassic animals can be linked to a number of elements that made them unusual and frequently bizarre. By knowing about unique species, we get an idea of how the world, climate, and wilderness was in historic times. We get to know about several new concepts we never knew ever existed. Do you know that there lives a broad category of mammals that includes a striking variety of hoofed creatures found all across the world? Click the video on your screen to know more about it.